So we're gonna do Peru Mobile, but I see like the level is very different. So who has never done a Peru Mobile yet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I can just watch.
Then I would say we start. I go over all the details and don't put it like too advanced. Okay. Let's start first with the exercise everyone does on his own. Okay, just to make sure we get the routine at least right. Okay. We just start like flat on the mat. I'm gonna roll over the shoulder, but I try to be more on my back and not too much here, like on my neck. I show how it's kind of wrong. And then you go here and you go all the way up. You see my neck. And by the turn. Okay, that's uncomfortable. That's not comfortable for me, and I feel like, oh, my neck hurts, and then maybe like to push me a bit hurts more. So what I want to do is I try to stay as long as I can on my back when I touch the leg before. It depends a little bit on your flexibility, if you're able to lay like more on the back or less. Okay, but usually a roll should look like this. Okay, I go here, then you go down, you bring the head in. You can help with your legs if you need to. So I go up. You see, like I'm on my back. Here, and here I feel more comfortable. And then I finish the roll. It's a little bit faster, I go here. So, and I roll. You can help a little bit with your elbows and your legs if you need to, like doing this, stepping. Or if you want to do it like, if you already feel like good doing it, just stay more loose, keep the legs loose, lift the hips, and switch. Okay, just try that a couple of times and then we go over the technique. 3, 2, 1. Let's just do the Peru Mobile roll. Okay, so. Let's start from both guys sitting. Okay. First, I want to get a tight hook on his leg. I want to control his leg, okay? Which is also called a Della Hiba hook. Okay? That means my left leg is going to the inside and the hook is tight. Okay? I grab his ankle and now I want to put a little bit of pressure on the leg. Okay? I don't want to keep it like very loose. I want to put a little bit of pressure on the leg. Okay? The other leg can just step on his leg. Now grab the belt. And now I do the same roll we just did. I just can help myself now with the belt. Okay? Which looks like this. I roll on my shoulder. So I bring the top leg close to the hip and the other leg can stay here as well. And then I try to be in this position and not here. Okay, so I try to be here. That's just the first roll. Okay. I just want you guys to go to this position and then come all the way back. But just to set up the Peru Mobile. Okay. Tight hook, I pull the ankle, I step, I grab the belt. Okay. I pull the belt, now I roll in and I end here. Okay. Keep the one leg on the hip, you can keep the other leg here too for now. Okay. Just to go here, I go back and one more time. Up. 1, 2, roll over the shoulder, bring the top leg to the hip, now both legs are here, I keep spinning, okay, if you feel here uncomfortable, keep spinning until your head's free, okay, and then just go back, and start one more time, okay, switching back and forth, 3, 2, 1, okay. I know it's hard to do it the first time, it's like weird, and especially as soon as you're inverted, you feel like, I don't know, where's top, where's bottom, I have no idea which way to go. Okay, you need to practice it. The more you practice, the more you feel like safe. It's the same with, let's say, a penetration step or something. The first time feels awkward, the more you do it, the better it gets, and the more you feel comfortable. Okay, so, I stay here, okay, push the leg a little bit to the side, so the knee is not bothering you. Some people were too loose. And then you try to go, and then the knee is bothering you. Okay. So push the knee away, grab, and now I go all the way over. You see my legs are already in position. Some of you people are inverting, and then you stay too far.
You see my legs have no control now.
Okay. So what I need to do is, as soon as I go invert, I need to adjust the position and get tighter. Okay, like very close to him. So I'm here.
I roll. I put this leg here on his hip. I pull myself.
And now I get closer to him. Okay.
If you feel uncomfortable staying here, just spin a little bit more. And you see I can post now on my shoulder. Okay, maybe you feel a little bit more comfortable doing this for now. Okay, I stay here. Now, we do a little motion before we take the back that we need to do. We need to be able to do. Which means just try to cross the legs for now and pinch your knees. You see my right knee is on his hip and my left knee is on, in his calf. Just close the legs, okay, tight, and now use the knees to kind of make him roll a little bit. That's it, correct? Just to, from here, pull the legs tight and use the knee. Go back. Okay, I want you to do this carjacking motion. Using the knee and pushing his hips up. Okay, that's very important. If you be able to do this very good, the broom will get very easy. Okay, so one more time. One, I go here. I stay tight. I pinch my knees, just close the legs, and then you pull him.
You can lay flat on that.
Yeah.
Okay, now you see better. I use my knees to turn him. You don't need to cross the legs. I just feel like in the beginning it's easier to pinch the knees now because you feel like, oh, I can pinch. Okay, but it should be like this later. Okay, so my legs are on hips. And I make him roll, then he can just sit back, and now it's his turn. Okay? 3, 2, 1. I was not sure about how to do this with the knee. So I was doing kind of a roll, and I ended sometimes on the back of someone, but then the people, then I started to roll like better people, people who know how to defend, that are heavier, and I was not able to keep rolling to take the back or do anything else, okay? And I had a hard time, but as soon as I learned like this detail of using the legs to lift someone, okay, your life gets much easier. Okay, especially when you want to do burn ball. Okay, I show one more time. So I'm here, I stay tight, I pull, I roll, I place my leg, and see, the most important part is like this leg for now. Okay, so I hook, my hook is attached to his body, and my knee is pointing to the inside, to the hip. Okay, now I don't even need this leg because we will need to flex the leg, sup. And you see that he starts rolling. You're putting pressure on the leg and on the hip. So I'm here without my hands, using my knee, using the top leg. And now I roll. Okay, that's of course not enough because then he's internal and he just get up. And then I have nothing, right? So, you need to add something. To lift him easier, I use, of course, my hands. I will use my arm that's controlling the belt to grab the hip, okay? Which makes this version usable in yogi too, because I don't need to use the grips, right? So I'm here, control. I start rolling. I place my top leg on the hip. And now this hand goes to the other side and catches the hip. Okay. So I'm here, I have my good control on the leg. I have the control here. And now I kind of lift him up. Okay. As soon as I lift him, okay, I'll just keep like this so the people see better. Okay. You see, as soon as I start lifting, his leg comes off the mat. Okay. And that's the moment when I switch to the leg. And now I pull the leg over my shin and I place it right in front of me, in front of me. Sit well here and I end up taking it. I do one more time a little faster and then slowly again. So I'm here, I spin and I pull. Okay. If you do like all the extra, the solo exercises and combine it to once, will make it easy burn hold. So I'm here, controlling the ankle, controlling the belt. I start rolling. I get to this position, okay, where I have like control of the leg. I use my knee and this leg to lift him a little bit. Oh, sorry, can you go back? I forgot this. Okay, you grab with the arm the hip. So I will show later a version where he's flat on the mat when you can't get the back grip. Right? Okay. But for now, usually the people, they want to stay on top, so they don't want to fall back, because then it's too easy to free. Okay. So he's posting. I catch the hip. I keep lifting him until I feel his legs coming off. And then grab the leg.
Boom.
Different angle.
I want to cover one situation. A lot of times when I roll and I want to attack the berm roll, lots of people, they don't want to stay on top, okay, or try to just counter or defend the berm roll. They kind of lay flat on the mat because they just want to survive the position. They say, oh, you don't get my back, okay? Which is kind of, to be honest, it's harder to then take the back. But so the sweep gets easier, or getting to a leg drag position kind of already on top and you already have the pass. But if you still want to do a berm volo, you can do kind of a more, I don't know, like relaxed version. You don't need to lift the guy too much. Looks like this. So I stay here. I start rolling and I feel the guy gets very flat on me. Okay. So I kind of have two options. If you want to do berm volo still, you can lift him up a little bit and catch the hip, because then you get better control of him. Okay, you can just do this motion. But if you say, oh, I don't like this motion, I don't feel comfortable with doing it, or he's too heavy for me, I don't know, catch the other leg, get around, get a hook, catch now his leg, and now I pull him over my shin, and I just put my hips on the mat, keep rolling him, and now I push him further. So, and I will end up taking the back without the need of lifting him with my bottom knee. Okay, one time. So I'm here. I get good control. I start to roll. And now I feel, oh, he's very flat. Okay. Hook the leg. Okay, so you can pull it better to you. You can even just grab the leg. That's okay too. I feel it gets a little bit, you gain more control by overhooking the leg. And then diving under. One, two. You can even grab the pants if you want to. You pull the leg, okay, and I place my shin behind. And now I kind of just need to pull him a little bit and extending my leg. The first hook is already in, and it is.
Okay. And now your hands are on the belt all the time?
I just keep the belt. Because it's hard for me to reach for the back. You can grab the pants. That's what I do sometimes when I feel the belt's very loose. Okay, even start already with the pant grip. Okay, so that's okay, that's a good grip too. I roll, sup, I catch, I hook. Okay, and I just need to pull him. You see, I just pull him over my leg. You give him a little push maybe with the arms. And you just end up taking the back. Usually the belt grip is enough. It's basically already enough when you have the grip on the other arm. Like on the other leg. So leg. Using the shin again without the hands. Okay. And one more time. I prefer the other one, to be honest. I feel this one is easier to counter. Okay, but it's good to know. So I go here. I spin. I hook. Okay, always stay tight. Try to not be too far, then the technique will get harder.
Okay, and pay attention about this leg. You don't want to give him this leg, because then he will take your back or something worse. Okay? So keep the knee here. That's what's already defending the counterbearer ball. So it's harder for him when I have my knee here. Okay. I hook, overhook, I stay tight. I catch the leg, I can even catch the pants. I pull the leg, and I place my shin. Okay, pushing him with my shin. And then I extend. Always try to keep it tight. Sit back here, and finish it here.
3, 2, 1.
Pushing the leg away, and maybe can touch with the knee, but I can't place the leg. So what I do, if I can, I catch the hip again, always. So I catch the hip, and now because I can't bring the leg on the hip because it's pushing the leg away, I'm gonna put the leg behind the knee. Okay. So from here you have a couple of options. Okay. If you feel good, like you need to have a, you need to be able to do this. If you want to move fast, staying right here with both legs. Okay, if you feel like this is hard, there is easy ways. So I show you. So I go here, I want to burn pull. I adjust, but I still can't use the knee. I bring the knee behind the leg. I catch the other leg. And now I just put him down. Okay, so I push his legs down and I keep him here. Tight control. Okay. I don't want him to run away. Be patient about this leg. This leg needs to be like trapped on your chest. Otherwise, he will step on you and you will have a hard time. Okay. So I push this leg here. Okay. I catch the collar. I switch the legs. And then I get up. And leg here. Okay. And from here, you can take side control or eventually take the back again. One time. I show this version again, and then for the people that wants to try the version where I stay up. Okay. So I go here. I'm pushing my leg away. It's too hard to stay here. I place my knee, I catch his legs, and now I kind of push him a little bit to here. Pulling the leg in, okay? Grab the hip. And pull the elbow tight. I grab the collar and pull it a little bit tight. Don't stay too loose, but then you can recover the leg again. So I stay tight. I switch the hooks. And then get up. If you have a good grip here on the hip, you can even make the leg turn. Bring the knee in and maybe take the back knee. Okay? One more time. Push the leg away.
You grab the collar or not
is less important than staying tight. Okay, so he's not getting the leg back. Placing, pushing him, pulling the leg tight, flexing the leg so he's not escaping. Grab the collar, switch the hooks, switch it, and then I get up. I get up stepping with his leg. I don't want to do this. Because then I feel like he didn't change anything in his position. It was just laying, right? Didn't move him. So I want to make the position a little bit more tight by stepping with this leg actually on the mat. Okay. See, it's more turned. I have some control here. I place my head on the opposite side, pinch my knees, and I stay tight. From there you can touch the head and just end up touching it. One more time, press it. Power.
just show one more time the version I told you guys before, when I stay up on the shoulder. Helps me sometimes, because some people, when I do it too sloppy,
they kind of try to stand up, like over me.
Yeah.
Okay, and then sometimes I end up in a good position, sometimes in a bad position. Okay. Anyways, I try to back up, so when I place my knee, I stay already here, catching the leg.
And then I take it back.
Because as soon as I get this control with the knee in, I think I will be the first one to stand up. Okay? Of course, as long as he's not stepping on me. So it's very hard for me to get on top. But I do this.
Okay? 3, 2, 1.